Anyway, well, anyway, here's the story. Here's the story. So I'm waiting for a train in Penn Station, and there's this girl who is pretty much engaged in, I'm in TGI Fridays, and she's engrossed in what's going on ESPN News about Tim Tebow. And I'm like, do you really care about the Jets? Because she didn't really look like a sports fan. And she goes on to tell me that she's Tim Tebow's number one fan, and her name is Vicky, and she's with us now. And she's actually gotten – she should be happy. She actually bumped a potential Hall of Fame baseball player to get this spot. So, Vicky, you're on with Mike Silva here on GBB. How are you?
Hi, Mike. How are you?
Good. Now, do you know who Dale Murphy is?
No, but I bumped him, apparently.
You bumped him? Well, he gave us the wrong number. You gave us the right number. Dale Murphy gave us the wrong number. Dale Murphy...
Hey, if there's any chance that Tebow can hear about me and how much I love him, I'll take it.
Well, I guess that's the story. And you got Brian, my producer, laughing in the background because apparently, you know, I said that you were the number one Tebow fan out there, and I was about to tell the story, but I said, you know what? It was too funny for me to tell it. You have to tell it. So... Why? No, I guess I'll start. Tell me, you love Tim Tebow. How did you learn about him? Was it back in college? Was it when he moved to the Jets? Was his great run with the Broncos?
It was back when he was in the Gators. I just thought he was hot.
You thought he was hot.
I just became a fan of him that way.
So you didn't care about his quarterback play?
No. I mean, I'm not like the biggest sports fan in the world, you know. Like I like Sunday Funday, but I don't know what's that. I don't know what's going on.
And what's Sunday Funday? What is Sunday Funday?
You know, when you watch football and you drink.
Okay, I just want to make sure.
Like, I like to go out and be social, but I don't know what's going on in the game.
That's right.
The football
is just background noise. That's right.
Exactly. So it gives drinking a purpose, right?
It does. Well, it also gives gambling. See, drinking and gambling have... beverage companies and gamblers love Sunday football from about September the 4th till, I guess, February the 4th. All right, so now you follow Tebow in college... But that's not enough. So you now have gone an extra mile because you want to meet Tim Tebow, right? Am I correct?
I want to meet him. My whole goal in life is to meet him.
That's the only goal you have left. If you met Tim Tebow tomorrow, your life would be complete.
I could die a happy woman.
So Rangers fans, 1994, Rangers fans said they could die in peace because they won the Stanley Cup. Vicky now, if she meets Tim Tebow tomorrow, she could die in peace. You got to see the look on my producer Brian's face over there.
I got ready for this interview, just so you know. So I'm wearing my Florida Gator sweats. I'm wearing my Tebow Foundation T-shirt, and I'm wearing my Jets hat.
Oh, look at that. There you go. You got the whole thing. All right, so tell the listeners how you got – now, you decided you have to meet Tim Tebow. Clearly,
by any means,
clearly going to Giants Stadium at the time, or it's MetLife Stadium now with the Jets, or flying out to Denver to Mile High and trying to meet Tim Tebow, not realistic. You decided to use the backdoor method. Talk about that.
Well, I know that he volunteers, obviously. He has the Tim Tebow Foundation, and he calls upon, if you join the foundation, he calls upon you to volunteer in your community.
Right.
And it states on the website that there are chances are he could be volunteering at the same events that you volunteer at. So I joined the Tim Tebow Foundation, and I wear my shirt, and I volunteer, and I help people, essentially. But really, I'm just doing it to hope that one day I get to meet him at an event. What I really kind of despise.
So you really, you really have no intention of doing. So here's the thing. So if Tim Tebow did not exist.
Wrong. I like helping people that need it, but most of these people are just gross, and they gross me out.
So what kind of volunteering are you doing?
Well, it's like, you know, helping people at a soup kitchen and, you know, helping people. So, like, you know, you help, you make their meals and you feed them.
So you're actually doing good work. You're doing good work.
They're outside smoking cigarettes.
They're outside smoking cigarettes.
I'm inside. I'm sweating in the kitchen trying to create mashed potatoes, and they're, like, smoking a pack of cigarettes. But, you know, it's Tim Tebow.
And how often do you do this?
Well, I do it, you know, obviously I do it around work, so I'll do it like twice a month.
So you're volunteering twice a month at something you really don't
to
like
people.
To do. To help people, begrudgingly, may I add. Begrudgingly.
I like to help people who are in need of help.
Okay. But you really hope Tim Tebow shows up.
Oh, my God, I would die if he showed up. Well, and I'd be wearing my shirt.
What shirt is that? Do you have a Tim Tebow shirt?
It's a Tim Tebow Foundation shirt that he wants you to wear it when you're volunteering, so people know that you're there to help.
Sounds kind of like a cult.
And that you care about people.
All right, so you have that down. So here's a piece of advice I think we have. Tim Tebow's kind of busy the next September, October, November, December, January, 6 months, you probably could put the volunteer on a hiatus till about February. So I give you a, you could put it on hiatus if you really, you know, if it really is a big deal. Now, here's the bigger question.
No, but see, now here's my opportunity because now I know he's local, right? So he could be volunteering on his off days.
Well,
in a local.
In case you're wondering,
in the community.
In case you're wondering, and it doesn't really matter much because Dale Murphy clearly didn't get our tweet because he hasn't called us. But we tweeted at Tim Tebow to say that you were coming on, that you're his number one fan, and we haven't heard back yet from him. So
I am his number one fan, and I would die to meet him.
What did you think about what Boomer Esiason said earlier in the week, that he should be cut?
Well, I mean, obviously Boomer Esiason looking for a little press, right? So
right.
You mentioned Tebow, you're getting some press.
You're getting
but
some press.
I thought the way Tebow handled it was very eloquent and gracious.
You don't think it was phony?
Like, do I think what?
Don't you think he's a little phony? He almost is like a robot.
He's perfect. He's absolutely perfect. There's nothing wrong with him.
Wow.
There's really, you can't find any dirt on this guy. He's awesome. He's just an awesome human being.
All right. Well, here's the deal. We'll give you a chance here. So now you got your last shot here. Before you could give any information, if you want to give the charitable organization a pop, let's at least do something good here. What's your message?
The Tim Tebow Foundation.
If Tim Tebow is in front of you right now, and if he's listening, so Tim Tebow, if you're listening, what message do you want to get to him?
That I love helping people, and that I love him, and I really want to meet him.
All right.
And I'll continue. Don't you think he would be happy to know that I'm doing something I'm clearly uncomfortable doing,
yeah,
but I'm helping people?
I guess.
In the meantime,
there's a happy ending to everything. Now, here's the thing: if you happen to meet Tim Tebow because of this program, what are you going to do for Brian and I? Because Brian was the one who handled the phone call eloquently, got you on the air, and he calmed you down. I saw him calming you down because you were a little nervous.
I was very nervous.
And I have gone out on a limb here to tweet all this stuff and put myself at huge ridicule as a very respected member of the
sports community.
What are you going to do for this program?
What would you like me to do for the program?
I'm asking you. I don't have any. I really don't know. I mean, do you want to do the switchboard and give Brian?
I don't know.
Off?
Maybe if I meet Tim Tebow, maybe I'll ask him to come on your program.
Well, I think the Jets media department might supersede that. All right. So it's Tim Tebow Foundation. Any other charitable causes you want to pop out
You know,
there?
It's his birthday's in 2 days, so happy birthday to me.
Well, Vicky, I know this is the late Sunday night hour, and here's the thing. You've got two things. You came on Mike Silva's radio show, which is a very rare opportunity for a non-sports personality.
I hear. You're the man.
That's true. And you bumped a potential Hall of Famer in Dale Murphy, so just
he's only
keep
a
that.
Potential Hall of Famer.
There you go. All right, Vicky. Well, we'll send the regards to Tim, and hopefully he gets it. And I'm sure we'll keep in touch. If you meet Tim Tebow, we'll get you back on the air. All right.
Thank you.
All right. That's Vicky. I think she's from New Jersey.